General, is it true that President Roosevelt, before he died, promised you a combat command in the Pacific?
Yes, he did, but now that he's gone, I don't think there's much chance of that. Doug MacArthur doesn't want me up there.
We've been told about these wonder weapons the Germans were working on. Long-range rockets, push-button bombing, weapons that don't need soldiers.
Wonder weapons? Thank God I don't see the wonder in them. Killing without heroics, nothing is glorified, nothing is reaffirmed. No heroes, no cowards, no troops, no generals. Only those who are left alive and those who are left dead. I'm glad I won't live to see it.
It's been pointed out, General, that you're still using former Nazis in key positions, despite the official denazification policy.
Well, if I'm supplied with trained personnel, I'll get rid of the Nazis. Until then, I'll use the people who can run the railroads and keep the telephones working.
After all, General, didn't most ordinary Nazis join the party in about the same way Americans become Republicans or Democrats?
Yes, that's about it.
You do agree, don't you, General, that our national policy should be made by civilians and not by the military?
Of course I agree. But the politicians never let us finish. They always stop short and leave us with another war to fight.
You thinking about our Russian allies?
Sir, did you say if you found your army between the Germans and the Russians, you'd attack in both directions?
No, I never said that. I never said any such thing. But I wish I had.
Sir, there's a call on your line from Supreme Headquarters, General Smith.
Beetle?
Ike is furious. How could you possibly compare the Republicans and Democrats to the Nazi Party? And this statement that you refuse to denazify has everybody screaming, the Russians, the British, everybody.